The night sky over Eastern Europe is heavy and silent. Somewhere far beyond the clouds, a radar pulse travels. Invisible, searching, hungry. Across the horizon, a Tomahawk missile cuts through the wind, a whisper of American steel aimed toward a broken front. And in that same darkness, deep inside a Russian command post, the S-400 awakens. Monitors glow, coordinates lock, metal breathes. For every missile that rises, there is one question left hanging in the air. If America's Tomahawk flies toward Ukraine, can Russia's S-400 destroy it before it ever meets the Earth? The answer, if it comes, could decide whether this century descends into fire or silence. In the heart of Russia's defense industry, the rhythm never stops. Inside Almaz Antey's vast assembly halls, the clang of metal blends with the hum of precision machinery. Technicians work in shifts that never truly end as launchers, radar arrays, and canisters take shape under pale industrial light. What began as a slow production line years ago has transformed into an industrial surge. Each S-400 battery rolling off the line is more than a weapon. It's a message. From the icy ranges of Kaliningrad to the fortified zones around Crimea, Moscow aims to weave an unbroken network of air denial, a shield of speed, reach, and silence. Steel becomes policy, engineering becomes strategy, and every completed system carries the weight of deterrence into the modern battlefield. The S-400 is not a single missile, but an entire ecosystem. At its core lies a family of interceptors. The 40N6, for distant threats up to 400 kilometers away. The 48N6, for high altitude engagements. The agile 9M96, for low, fast, twisting targets. Each missile type serves as a layer in a vertical wall of protection built to engage everything from stealth aircraft to low-flying cruise missiles. Supporting them are eyes that never sleep. The 91N6E Big Bird Acquisition Radar, the 92N6 Gravestone Fire Control Radar, and the 96L6 Engagement Array, all synchronized through a digital command system that can manage dozens of simultaneous tracks. Linked to shorter range systems like the S-350 Vityaz and the Pantsir, it forms a defense web so intricate that even Western pilots admit it is a system one studies, not one to test. Each upgrade sharpens the invisible edge. And in modern warfare, invisibility, not firepower, is the true advantage. Detection, tracking, lock, launch, intercept, five steps, five heartbeats. The S-400's radar scans the sky, identifying a hostile signature. A digital brain computes the trajectory, while the command unit selects the best missile. The launcher tilts, hydraulic arms rise, and within seconds, a column of flame pierces the night. The missile climbs, arcs, and dives, its seeker locking onto the target with the precision of a predator. No heroics, no sound, just fragments of metal and a quiet confirmation, target destroyed. Each shot is a calculation, not of power, but of time. Because in air defense, milliseconds decide whether a nation breathes or burns. To the Russian military, the S-400 is not simply a weapon. It's geography turned into armor. Each system is positioned to form concentric circles of protection. Over Moscow, over the Arctic routes, along the western border, and in overseas posts like Syria. Together, These rings create what strategists call a 2/AD zones, anti-access, area denial sectors designed to keep enemy aircraft and missiles far from Russian soil. In theory, any foreign aircraft entering that airspace could be tracked before it even crosses the line of sight. It is both shield and signal. An unspoken warning that behind every radar signature lies a decision maker ready to act. 1,000 kilometers of deterrence wrapped in circuitry and cold intent. Every system built by man carries its shadow. The S-400's reach is vast, but not invincible. It can be overwhelmed by swarm tactics, saturated with decoy drones, or blinded by electronic warfare designed to jam its frequencies. Western militaries train relentlessly to exploit those vulnerabilities: low-level flight paths, stealth codings, coordinated missile salvos. Yet for all its potential weaknesses, one truth remains. The S-400 alters the psychology of war. It forces caution. It slows offensives. It changes how enemies think long before they ever act. And sometimes, in strategy, fear itself is the weapon. In recent months, Western analysts have discussed the possibility of the United States providing Ukraine with long-range Tomahawk missiles, a move that, if realized, would mark a new phase in escalation. To Moscow, such a step blurs the line between support and participation. To NATO, it is a deterrent, a promise of reach and precision. But in the space between those two interpretations lies danger. If Tomahawks were ever launched across contested skies, Russian radar networks would react instantly. A single misread signal, a single intercepted missile, could spiral into something far beyond local defense. Because for the S-400, the act of interception is not just technical, it's political. And for the world watching, each engagement brings us closer to a question no leader wants to answer. When does defense become the spark of something uncontrollable? The S-400 stands as both guardian and omen. Its radars spin beneath snow and fog, listening to the sky, waiting for echoes that might never come. Or might come too soon. In an era where missiles speak louder than diplomats, the hum of an air defense radar can sound like the ticking of a global clock. Perhaps that is the most frightening truth, that the next war may not begin with a declaration, but with the sound of a lock tone in the night. Disclaimer: this narrative is based on open-source defense analyses and does not claim verified combat data. All geopolitical implications are explored for educational and analytical purposes only.